time. They say you heal all wounds, but they don't talk about how you destroy all that's good in the world. How you turn beauty into ash. And that's some bullshit, Howard. If love is creation and death is destruction, I'm just a terrain in between. You don't understand time. No one understands time. I mean, Einstein came close when he said I was an illusion.
Howard, hey, listen, I'm sure it's a no, but Oneida Apparel asked that you be in the media buy meeting. I'm sorry to just barge in.
Ask her. Go ahead, ask her if she can see me.
I'm not gonna be in the meeting.
Mm-hmm. Oh, they insisted I ask. I mean, they're probably gonna fire us, so.
Okay.
Awesome.
Yes.
See you later.
You can have these back, Howard. Why did you write me anyway? You wrote me because you need me.
No, I don't need anything from you, okay?
You all like to bitch and complain. There isn't enough time. Life is short. Oh, here, the gray hairs are coming in. You know, a day is long as hell. I'm abundant. I'm a gift. Even while you're standing here talking shit, I'm gifting you. And you're wasting it. On what? And what is this? Huh? You know, I should be the one that's writing angry letters.
So then the girl looks at the cord. You know, this cord that has fed them, has nourished them. This cord that they can't possibly conceive could be attached to anything else. And she says, well, we have no proof. All we have is this.
No. Wow, that's deep. So it's like life after birth. Hopeful. All right, what do you want? Why are you here? I've heard all of your platitudes. I got them, I know. She's in a better place. And this is all a part of a master plan. Heard that one too. Here's my favorite. God looked down and saw the most beautiful rose, so beautiful that he picked it to have it in heaven all for himself. Then there's the science, biocentrism, and we're all living and dying in infinite universes all at the same time. And then the religion, the Christians and their salvation, and the Buddhists and their samsara, and the Hindus and their 41st sacrament. And can't forget the poetry. Oh, the poetry. To die is different from what anyone supposed. And luckier, Whitman. And rage! Rage against the dying of the light. The wise men at their end know dark is right. Thomas. And then row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Merrily, 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 life is but a dream. I got it. I got it. It all basically says that you're a natural part of life. We shouldn't hate you. We shouldn't fear you. I guess we should just accept you, right? That's it.
Hi, Howard.
Yeah. You gonna cry again?
You don't like it when I'm sad?
Yeah. Aren't you always sad?
No. No, I can be other things. I can be happy. I can be unexpected and unpredictable and...
Sure.
And sexy and warm and mysterious and home. I can be home, Howard, remember? Do you remember me?
Listen, all the fabric of life bullshit, save that for somebody else.
Bullshit. I know you don't believe me, but you have to trust me.
Trust you? Trust you?
Yes.
I did trust you. And you betrayed me. I saw you every day in her eyes. And I heard you in her voice when she laughed. And I felt you inside of me when she called me daddy. And you betrayed me. You broke my heart.
No. I'm in all of it. I'm the darkness and the light. I'm the sunshine and the storm. Yes, you're right. I was there in her laugh. But I'm also here now in your pain. I'm the reason for everything. I am the only why. Don't try and live without me, Howard. Please don't.